Hello everyone, and welcome on a new episode in today's analysis. This time we are going to analyze Freddy Krueger, the main antagonist of a Nightmare on Elm Street franchise. One of the most iconic villains in horror genre, Freddy left a long-lasting impact upon the pop culture since his inception back in 1981. From this video, I'm going to analyze all the information about Freddy Krueger and his journey from a simple orphan and sadistic child killer in life to the diabolical dream demon he has become in death. Now, with no further introduction, let's begin. Frederick Charles Krueger was born on May 6, 1942, to his mother, Amanda Krueger, and an unknown father. Amanda got pregnant with Freddy after she was raped by the 100 Maniacs on the Christmas of 1941, after she was accidentally locked up with them. Upon his birth, Freddy was set up for adoption, and Amanda changed her name into Sister Maria Elena. Upon growing up, Freddy was moved from orphanage to orphanage. Eventually, he was adopted by an abusive alcoholic man known as Edward Underwood and was bullied by the other children for the fact that he is a rape child. Now, in his late teenage years, Freddy finally killed his diabolical stepfather as revenge for all the abuse he endured from him. But that wasn't enough, as Freddy wanted revenge on his classmates as well. So he started a killing spree in Springwood, in which he would kill all the children of his former classmates as revenge for their bullying over him. He would eventually also marry a woman named Loretta, and together they would have a daughter, Catherine, and his son Freddy would portray the image of a family father in order to hide his true colors underneath. And he would also gain the nickname of the Springwood Slasher for all the murders he committed, killing at least 20 children and spreading their remains throughout Springwood. And when his wife found out, and his daughter too eventually, he killed his wife in front of their daughter, and only spared Catherine after she promised that she won't tell on him, which she did, which led to his arrest in 1968, from which in his daughter he was taken away from him, and adopted by another family, and had her name changed. Upon the news of his supposed murders, his mother Amanda Krueger committed suicide. However, some cops have forgotten to fill the papers regarding his arrest, and because of that, Freddy was set free. Angered by the lack of justice, the parents of Springwood officially took the justice in their own hands, and they burned Freddy alive while he was at the power plant where he worked on, as he planned to move from Springwood and begin a new killing space in another town. Yet upon his death, Freddy made a deal with a trio of dream demons in which he would be able to return back from the dead into their dreams, into the dreams of people, especially children, as an exchange for him to become the agent of chaos. And Freddy made a deal, as upon the death of his body, he will come back as a malevolent dream demon, which will kill innocent people, including especially children, in their dreams. Eventually, for the next 13 years, Freddy will be presumed dead, until he came back as a malevolent dream demon and came in conflict with Nancy Thompson in 1981, J.C. Walsh in 1984, Crystal Parker in 1987, Alice Johnson in both 1988 and 1989, and his daughter, Catherine Krueger, now known as Maggie Burutz, in 1991, who he desired to kill as revenge for telling on him, as well as his desire to move from Springwood and kill all the children in the world once he was done. Thankfully for everyone, he failed, as Catherine managed to find and to kill her father and avenge her mother's death, and as well as all the other children. Yet, unfortunately, this wasn't the end for Freddy Krueger, as he was able to come back 12 years later, by 2003, where he resurrected another immortal serial killer, Jason Voorhees, in order to return to Springwood and start a new killing spree in order to make people to remember Freddy so that they could fear him once again. Now, before we finish this video, we can ask ourselves, is Freddy Krueger evil? Now, I bet all of you wonder right now, why do I bother to ask that, given the fact that we've seen everything he did throughout the film. Yet, it's worth analyzing that Freddy has a genuine tragic backstory, as coupled with the fact that he was conceived through rape, abandoned by his mother, abused by his foster father, and bullied by the other children. Freddy technically didn't have a happy upbringing at all. However, the fact that you are literally willing to kill innocent children in order to take revenge on their parents who only hurted you and wanted to kill the parents themselves is absolutely horrible and downright terrifying. Not to mention that Freddy had an actual happy marriage and a happy family, and they genuinely loved him, and he willingly rejected all of this for good. So, not to mention by the events of the film, Freddy has absolutely no redeeming qualities whatsoever, with the closest one I might find are his tragedy and the possible love that he might have for his daughter, and he rejected in the end when he attempted to kill her. So in the end, the answer to the question, is Freddy Krueger evil, is definitely yes, as he could easily be called as nothing short of pure evil. Yet in his ultimate plan, in order to make the people remembering him by using Jason, he came in conflict with Laurie Campbell and her friends, as well as making Jason his enemy for the fact that he killed the victim that Freddy wanted. Thus bringing all the protagonists and making Jason together to defeat him and making Jason some sort of an anti-hero. In the end, Freddy got what he deserved, as he was finally decapitated by Laurie and his head was taken by Jason. However, it's likely that Freddy is still alive. Alive and well, still killing people in the town of Springwood, Ohio. So in the end, who is Freddy Krueger? He is nothing more but just a simple orphan who had an unfortunate upbringing. An orphan that will become a sadistic serial killer, and upon that, a diabolical demon that will do anything in order to satisfy his sadistic pleasure. A monster that could be easily called as one of the evilest and the most iconic villains in all cinema. Thanks for watching, everyone. Don't forget to like and subscribe, or Freddy will come after you in your dreams. Bye!
You are all I kill.